Hello again, my name is Guillermo Felices and I'm the Head of Research and Strategy in the Multi-Asset team at MAQS. Today I will walk you through the main points in our latest publication. Following a strong quarter where asset prices rallied across the board, the second quarter was a more challenging one for markets. The most salient theme was a continuation of the fixed income rally in major markets. Global equity markets were more volatile, with May seeing a broad correction only to give way to a strong bounce in June. These moves reflect cross currents coming from three different sources: trade tensions, central banks, and macro data. Let's take a look at how these factors have evolved as they are crucial for asset allocation decisions. Investors have been worried about weakening macro data since the soft patch of Q4 2018. True activity data generally softened in 2018, but we're seeing signs of stabilization, notably in the US. Combined with low inflation, softer but stable growth in major economies should be enough to support a benign environment for risky assets. Central banks have also been a major market driver this past quarter. Indeed, the ECB and the Fed made a significant dovish turn that many interpreted as paving the way for further easing. In China, policy easing is already underway, both on the monetary and fiscal sides. These dovish turns reflect a combination of slowdown fears, low inflation, and uncertainty about the prospects of trade wars, and they typically support risky assets, depress real rates, and revive inflation break-even rates. Finally, trade tensions between China and the US were on the rise in May. This hasn't surprised us, as we expect this risk to oscillate around a medium to long-term trend of deglobalization. But expectations of relief were building ahead of a crucial meeting between presidents of both countries around the G20 meetings. As it turned out, both countries agreed a truce on further tariffs and to restart trade negotiations. We characterize the combination of moderate growth, low inflation, and dovish central banks as a fragile Goldilocks environment. We believe this could last for longer, especially if inflation remains contained and if trade tensions ease more decisively over the next few months. But we call it fragile because there are risks that could destabilize this sweet spot. In terms of our asset allocation, a Goldilocks environment should support market risk generally, and equities in particular. But given the ongoing cross currents, we expect equities to trade within a volatile, slightly upward tilted range. Our roadmap is therefore to buy equities on dips. This is exactly what we did in developed market equities over the past quarter. This environment also makes carry trades attractive, as a further compression in real yields should support high yielding assets. We remain long emerging market hard currency debt and are looking for tactical entry points on other high yield assets. We also see scope for break-even inflation to move higher, especially in the US, given the combination of a dovish Fed and an economic outlook that is still supportive of higher inflation. Finally, we continue to favor building robust portfolios. We're monitoring several risks that could destabilize markets, such as trade wars, and we hold trades that protect our portfolios against them. That's it for me. See you next time.